So you can't always summarize. So if we have these four networks, 10.6500, 10.6510, 10.128.2.0, and 10.128.3.0. So if we take a look and find our ranges for each address, what we have is 10.65.0.0 as our first network. The broadcast address for that is 10.65.0.255. The next network, 10.65.1.0, follows right after our broadcast for the first network. The broadcast address for the 1.0 network is 10.65.1.255. Then we have 10.128.2.0. Its broadcast address is 10.128.2.255. And then last, 10.128.3.0, with a broadcast address of 10.128.3.255. This means that our ranges of addresses here go from 10.65.0.0 through 10.65.1.255, and then again from 10.128.2.0 through 10.128.3.255. There's a giant chunk in the middle missing there from 10.65.2.0 through 10.128.1.255. We don't have any of those numbers in there. When we try to use the method, though, that I taught you now of matching like bits with these four addresses, we match up our bits. Our first bit zeros, 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 ones, zeros, ones, zeros. And then our ninth bit is 11 for the last two addresses and 00 for the first two. Well, what this means is that our summary boundary then happens between the eighth and ninth bits, which makes the range of addresses here 10000/8, which includes 10000 through 10255255255. That's a lot of addresses. That's a lot more addresses than our ranges that we identified initially, which were 10.65.0.0 through 10.65.1.255. This range includes that and a whole lot more. And we may not want all those extra addresses in there. As a matter of fact, it's my recommendation that whenever we're doing summarized routes, that we make them as specific as possible or don't do it at all. So one of the two. If our summary route is going to overlap with other networks in our environment, we don't want to do that. And by overlap, I mean in this 10000/8, that includes basically every address in the 10.000 IP space. Well, we're only using 10.65.0.0 through 10.65.1.255, and then another range of 10.128.2.0 through 10.128.3.255. This range incorporates a lot more numbers if we are using the 10 dot address space elsewhere in our environment. We can end up creating problems. So we can't do this. So what we do is instead is we look at our addresses and we examine them and find where we can actually do route summarization. In this case, if we just examine our first two network addresses, we can then move our summary boundary between bit number 23 and 24 here and do a 10.65.0.0/23 to summarize our first two networks and ignore the second two networks. So if we ignore the second two networks, then we can actually create a range then of 10.65.0.0 through 10.65.1.255, giving us our first range. So our network address then for our summary route becomes 10.6500/23. And then we find a summary boundary again, this time for our second two networks. This time our boundary ends up being in the same exact spot as the first 23 bits of these two addresses are exactly the same. So here, 10.128.2.0/23 ends up being my summary address, and that gives me my second network address that I can use to summarize. Now with these two addresses, 10.6500/23 and 10.128.2.0/23, I can successfully summarize those two networks. I just can't summarize the two 10.65 networks with the two 10.128 networks without including more addresses than I wanted to. So sometimes we can't summarize an address in the way that we want it to. So this wraps up route summarization. I look forward to seeing you in future TrainSignal videos. Thank you.